All right, let's get back to Frank. We know you're tracking Laura, but also quick sunset. How about that?
I tell you what, the calm before the storm, right?
Always great.
Beautiful sunset tonight. Just enough moisture from Marco and the leftovers to give us some dramatic sunsets. Hope to get to more as we continue during this hour. This is from Nick Batesel. Clear Lake sunset. Isn't that gorgeous?
That is.
Absolutely beautiful. I got a lot of them like that. So we'll get to them. In the meantime, Trigall Energy Cameras 85. East northeast winds, again, because of Marco at 15 miles an hour. Looking fairly quiet. A little hard to see there in Galveston right now. 86 northeast winds there at 18. So one more time on this track. Category 1 hurricane, 90 mile an hour winds, gusting to 115. West northwest at 17. A category 3 moving into the Sabine Pass and Lake Charles area. That's the forecast for tomorrow between midnight Wednesday and 2 in the morning on Thursday. That looks to be the timing for this right now. And you can see we're not in the cone any longer, but that doesn't mean we won't feel effects, especially at the coast. So we'll talk about those. There's the category 3 to still a 1. There's going to be so many power outages in East Texas and Western Louisiana, and then that wraps back around into the Mid-Atlantic. So look at this wind forecast. Keep in mind that the orange is a cat 2, the red is a 3, and the purple that shows up a little bit is actually a 4. I'm going to put some pause points here because that's going to be pushing a lot of water toward our coast. Be aware of that. I think you're going to see some strong tides coming into the Galveston, the Bolivar Peninsula area, and even into the bay. So a lot of those roads that sort of tied Ville Road and the Blue Water Highway at 87. 3005, they all go underwater. With 3 feet, they'll go underwater. So be careful of that tomorrow, and then we'll get some back building a possibility as this system comes in. There will be such strong winds across the bay that could actually back up the drainage system in Galveston and push water into the streets. That can be problematic, clearly. The damage increases exponentially, and the reason I want to show you this is that 115 mile an hour winds, and that's what's being forecast, 115 to 120. 115 is 30 times the damage potential of just a 75 mile an hour Cat 1 minimal hurricane. So from a 75 to 115, which is in the forecast, and even stronger than that, is 30 times. You get to 130, and that's the European model, is forecasting 130 mile an hour winds right there at a Cat 4. That's 82 times the damage of a 1. It's like an earthquake that can bigger and bigger and bigger. This is still the warmest basin, 88 to 90 degrees. The warmest basin in the whole world right now is the Gulf of Mexico. We have the tropical storm warnings. We also have hurricane warnings, and those do extend all the way into inland Harris County. It just simply means hurricane force winds are a possibility, and that's 74 miles plus. So that's possible that you would see that as this system continues to push across. Also, the storm surge watches and warnings, and this is for 6 to 9 feet of storm surge, Bolivar Peninsula to High Island, 3 to 5 Galveston into the bay, 2 to 4 down towards Surfside. So don't let your guard down. Let's look at the models there. Is the look for the American FUTURECAST rainfall. That brings in 10 to 12 inches of rain. If this slows down at all, that's going to happen. But I think generally 6 to 8 is going to be fairly common. We've had that low and this high. That's been directing everything. It's kind of interesting. This is the satellite picture. I want to show you along this arrow how this has been running along. We've just been watching this. That's why earlier today I was calling for this to continue on more of a northwest track. As you can see, that's the center of the system right there. That's the eye of the storm, and it's actually jogged a little north of that arrow. So as it continues to push across, I think it may end up on the, that's why I said earlier, the eastern edge of that cone. You can see it right there. So we'll watch for that. There's the leftovers from Marco. Low pressures follow low pressure. I think that's what's happening. That low pressure was set, and that's the American model. That's continuing to move right in here. So you got that, the American into Lake Charles, and then we've got the European, which is going to go generally right into Sabine Pass. So they're lining up beautifully there. They're right into Sabine Pass. That's the European. Here's the RPM model, and you can see from this, we start to feel at least some outer bands and effects tomorrow afternoon. That's 2:30. Look for the rain, the gusty winds, and then this continues to move right toward, again, a little to the west of Sabine Pass on the RPM. So if you compare them, they are clustered here. away from us, and the official track for a 3 is the farthest to the east. So good news for us. West side, no worries. Central areas, really no worries. 15 to 30 mile an hour winds, maybe 20 to 30 overnight, 1 to 3 inches of rain. You get toward the coast, you get into 50 mile an hour winds on Wednesday evening, 75 Wednesday overnight, because you're close enough to that hurricane, and also some heavy rains are a possibility if you get any kind of banding around that system. Same for the zone impacts for the coast. We can see 3 to 5 foot surge, 4 to 7 on Bolivar, 6 to 9 east of High Island, 50 to 75 mile per hour winds. So we'll watch for all of that. For us, we're going to keep a close eye to everything. It looks like as we go toward the weekend, things for us continue to be at least a little bit on the stormy side. It's still summertime. We're still in August as we head toward the weekend.